Hello and welcome. In this video, we are going to learn how to process B2B inbound message in trading partner mode. We are going to consider transport communication as FTP, but the steps will hold true for AS2 as well. So the prerequisites for this are we need to have the B2B schema created if required, else we can use the standard B2B schema. We need to create a B2B document depending on the document type and the version which we are going to use for our communication. Host company details must be set up in the B2B. First two points in the prerequisite, that is creating B2B schema and B2B document, we have already covered in our previous videos on B2B. If you have not watched that video, please check out the video. I will give the link in the card section. Under B2B, you have to click on this host profile. If you have not set up your host profile, you will see here the my company and all those things will be empty. You need to define your host company based on which your partners will identify. We would need to pass this EDI, exchange ID, qualifier, group ID. In case of AS2 transport communication, we need to define AS2 identifier as well. In order to add any identifier, we have to click on this plus button. Okay. And in the drop down, we have to select. Suppose if you are integrating this from application, any application like Fusion or any other application, and there is a specific application ID which is being assigned for that app, then we can have this over here. So whenever the transaction happens for that particular application, then this ID will be displayed under monitoring. So like this, we have to add one by one identifier. The main thing what we need to add is EDI interchange ID and the EDI group ID. These are mandatory. And along with that, you can have this EDI exchange ID qualifier and EDI group qualifier as well. So this is how you have to set up your host company details. Coming to the actual steps for inbound message processing in the case of trading partner mode, the documentation by Oracle on B2B for Oracle integration. Here we have seen how we can set up this host company, okay, which is nothing but this host profile. Next is a trading partner setup. So under trading partner, we have to fill up the primary information, contact, and define B2B identifiers and define the transport and inbound agreement. Transport, we are making use of FTP in this video. So for that, we have to go to this trading partner. So before jumping into trading partner, make sure you have the B2B schema created if you require any custom schema for the document creation, and the document must be created. So I will be demonstrating for 850 4010 EDI X12 format. I have already created this partner 111. For demonstration purpose, I will create one another partner. In order to create a partner, click on this create button over here. Provide the name. I'm giving partner 222. Description, if any, you can give. Click on create. First of all, we need to add the contacts. Suppose if something goes wrong, the support team or any other business user may need to contact that person. I'm giving a dummy example.com mail ID. Coming to B2B identifiers, like how we have set up the interchange ID, group ID, and all for the host company, we need to define those for the trading partner as well. Suppose if we are sending the EDI file to a trading partner should, if they are having the validation at their end, they must make sure that the EDI file is from that so-and-so company and it is indented to for them. So for that purpose, I'm adding this interchange ID over here. Let me give something ABCD. So the group ID will add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like this, you can add the EDI exchange qualifier, group ID, or the group identifier qualifier as well. So the main thing is adding the transport and agreements over here. First, we need to define the transport. Again, all those details are documented over here, how the message will be routed between the integrations, the transaction type, that is receiving message or outbound. I will provide the link in the description. You can go through the link. I'm clicking on this FTP. If you are building a solution on AS2, you can click on this. Okay, so FTP is a file-based transport protocol. AS2 is based on HTTP. Here again, at the high level, it's written like what needs to be done. We need to create the agreement and we need to deploy it and all those stuffs. Okay, we can go through this. So in order to create a transport, click on this plus button over here. Provide the name. I'm giving partner 222 FTP transport. So I'm selecting the FTP base type transport protocol over here. We need to make sure you create the connection prior to coming over here. If not, you can click this plus button and create a connection. If not, we have to click this drop down arrow and select this OIC SFTP. This is the FTP connection which I have created in my integration. So the encoding, coming to encoding, I'm leaving this as UTF-8. We have to provide the inbound directory in our FTP server. giving one dummy thing over here. Scan recursively, because if your inbound folder is having subfolders, then it will read all the files in that subfolders. If you are looking for a specific pattern like star ADI, then we can provide it over here. Minimum age we can provide if the file is written in the FTP server beyond 5 seconds. I mean, if it's lying more than 5 seconds, then only it will be read. Maximum number of counts which will be picked in each scheduled run, I'm giving it as 5. In case of functional acknowledgement, if we receive the 850, we have to send back the 997 acknowledgement in most of the cases. So in that case, in which directory we have to send this file, from where the operating partner will pick the file. So this we have to define over here. I'm giving as output file name. We can provide the sequence, something like order underscore percentage seek percentage dot EDI. Samples given over here, we can go for the sequence, we can add the date, seconds as well. Coming to B2B integration, so two integrations will be created. One is for sending and one for receiving the data or the file. So the prefix for which we have to define it over here, I'm giving this as partner 222. So it will create two integrations. The name for which is displayed over here, it will create partner 222 FTP receive. Basically, this will be a scheduled integration, and this is exposed over HTTP, that is over REST. So the receive is a scheduled integration, okay, and the send is exposed as a REST service. So once done, click on add. Once you are added, if you want, you can edit or we can delete. Create a schedule for the scheduled integration, like if you have any ICAL expression or if you want that integration to run at a specified interval, then we can create this receive REST schedule and then we can deploy. I'm directly deploying this. Yeah, let it deploy and take its time. Meanwhile, we'll create an inbound agreement. So I'm over here, define inbound and outbound agreements. Under inbound, click on plus and select the document which we created. Provide the name, I'm giving as underscore inbound agreement. The drop down, we have to select the B2B document which we discussed just now, which under the prerequisites. So we have to create the B2B document and schema if required. Document we have to select it from here. Select the backend integration for the inbound. So we have to select this receive which we created just now and deployed. If you check mark this enable validation, then all the data will be validated against the schema of the B2B document. I don't want this to happen. I'm unchecking this enable validation. Generate functional acknowledgement. Whenever we receive 850, then 997 will be sent back to trading partner saying we have received the purchase order. So in that case, if you want acknowledgement to be sent, you have to check mark this, else we can ignore. Here, if you check mark this, it will basically validate the control numbers. I don't want this to happen in this case, but in actual business case, you might require. Click on add. So once inbound agreement is in place, we need to activate this. Now let's go to integration and verify. As you could see, it has created two integrations. One is partner 222 FTP receive and FTP send. This is for receiving or reading the EDI inbound messages from EDI file, and this is for sending the messages out, basically used for an acknowledgement in case of sending 997 EDI file. Okay, when you create for the first time, you will notice these two template integrations created, that is B2B integration template FTP receive and FTP send. So this is this will create only once, okay, based on which only these two integrations are customized for you. So coming to the steps, our trading setup, setting trading partner is done, primary contact B2B identifier is done, we have defined the transport inbound agreement. Now next thing is we have already deployed this inbound agreement, but we have to make sure we build the backend integration. The details for which is provided over here, inbound message processing over here, and that is how to define an inbound backend integration. We have to create an app driven integration for this, exposed to a REST connection, and the sample message is provided over here when it will receive the basic EDI file metadata and the message reference. Okay, and how it will read the data from persistent store and convert it to XML, all those three, and we have to select the document definition over here. If we need this data to be sent to any downstream application, we can do that by adding the connections appropriately. Okay, you can have a look at this anytime. So let me show you the backend integration which I have created, that is this backend inbound purchase order. So this integration I have created exactly by referring to this document, wherein we are receiving the B2B message reference from here, and we are converting that to XML with the help of this B2B action, and I'm just logging. In your case, you may need to call some other applications, Fusion Cloud or any other applications, that you can do it over here. I'm just logging it. Under fault handler, we have to mark as error in the B2B actions. Okay. Again, the details for which is provided over here. We can refer to this. I'm closing this and opening the partner FTP receive, which will receive the ADI file. So I have not modified anything. This is exactly what our B2B configuration has created for us. Only thing is this backend integration. Here, by default, there will be a backend integration created. We need to just edit it and select the backend integration which we have created and have the details. This is for inbound message. If you look at the condition, if the message group type is message and direction is inbound, then it will come over here. In case of 850, it will go to this flow. In case of outbound acknowledgement, that is when our 850 received, we have to send back 997. At that time, it will go over here and it will make use of that partner 222 FTP send or partner 321 FTP send, which we created from our B2B trading partner setup. It will be called and the EDI file will be shared. In case of any transaction errors, like if the group type is error, if there is any issue with that particular group, then the error will be raised and it will be logged. In your case, if you want to send email notification, you can modify it over here. In case of inbound acknowledgement, okay, suppose there is acknowledgement details as well clubbed in the same file. Suppose if the trading partner is sending 850 along with 997 of any other orders, then it will be considered as FA inbound. So it will come over here. Again, we have to process that information. We can create a backend application or backend integration. I have not created that for this for demonstration purpose, but you could create a backend integration and do whatever you have to do with the data. There are a few integration properties created. Suppose after reading the file, we want to delete that from the FTP, then we could do it here. From the integration property, I will show you. Again, those things are documented over here. You can always go over here and check the details. So those are the integration properties created. You can just come over here and check. I'm closing this. You have to come over here and click on this update property values and change the details. Okay. If you want to keep the files after reading the file, you have to give this keep always. If you want to delete, you can write this delete always. Again, how I know these things is from this documentation. Keep on error, delete always, keep always. You can have a look on this and update this integration parameters on your own. You can schedule this receive integration to run at a specified frequency right from the B2B console. Okay, from here by clicking on this receive schedule and then you have to redeploy. If you are not done, you can manually submit this as well. Suppose in this case, I'm assuming that our partner has sent an EDI file in the directory where we have defined, okay, while creating that transport. I will run this integration manually and go to monitoring and check. As you could see, in integration, everything got successful. That is, we have received 1850 inbound and it has invoked this FTP send to send the 997 acknowledgement and also it has triggered the backend application. Okay, we'll go over here and expand this and check our log message. The file which I have put is this one, wherein I'm sending the ISID of the partner or the host, okay, group ID of the sender and the receiver, and there is this segment. Okay, some dummy I have created just which is having 33 lines in particular transaction, that is for 850. Okay, and for this was the order. So from here it looks good. If you want to know each and every message on it details, you can click this activity and check. So this looks good. Backend application integration is called and it has succeeded. No errors. It has sent the 997 and we'll see if it has sent the 997, which we had. It should basically create in the outbound directory, which we had defined at the time of creating the transport. Now click on this and edit. Yeah, it has created the acknowledgement, okay, for the purchase order 1422. That is for the 1422. Okay, and it looks good. 997 has been put on the FTP for the trading partner to pick from here. Now let's go to our B2B monitoring and check. Yeah, both are successfully 850 and 997 for the partner 111. Okay, if you click on this, you can get the details in like for the message log, payload, and the correlations. Okay, these are the identifier which we have selected while defining the document. If you don't know how to do that, please watch our previous video on how to create B2B document and schemas, in which we have covered in detail. And 997 also transaction has been successful. Check the details anytime coming over here. Okay, which I have shown from the FTP directly. Using those steps, we can make use of a B2B trading partner setup and process inbound messages with the help of B2B in Oracle integration. In our next video, we'll go through how we can make use of B2B for Oracle integration and process the outbound messages, that is from host company to our trading partners. Thank you for joining us in this video.